What's up, guys? It's your boy, Barca Boy 103. Today we're going to be reacting to the Barcelona news over the past 24 to 48 hours. Basically, we're going to react to all the news after Bartomeu resigned. A lot of stuff has come out. We know a lot more information than we did a few days ago. So let's get straight into it. So we're going to start by reading the quotes from Bartomeu's final press conference as FC Barcelona manager. Starts by saying, "I appear to announce my resignation and that of my board of directors. It was thoughtful, calm decision I have taken in consultation with my colleagues. The government of Catalan asked us for the vote to be decentralized and haven't said anything else. They didn't respond to our request of 15 days to prepare the 21 venues, nor did they say anything about the date of referendum. These are contradictory and irresponsible decisions from the government. After the elimination of the Champions League, it would have been easy to resign. We could have left the club in the hands of a manager. We have been disrespected. There have been insults and threats to me, my family, and my other board members. It's been an honor to serve the club. Today we resign without having completed economic measures in process. I hope that the next few days the salary adjustments can be closed. It is not done. There will be serious consequences for the future of the club. I can announce some extraordinary news." This is where stuff gets real. "Yesterday we accepted the requirements to participate in a future European Super League that will guarantee the economic stability of the club. Today we have accepted the new format of the Club World Cup as well." So the details of these requirements will be made available for the next board, and the decision about participating in the competition shall be ratified by the new assembly of delegate members. So basically, if Bartomeu would have stayed as president, we would be in the Super League if the Super League were to form. He's saying that I have accepted it, but it's now up to the new board to, you know, go through with it. If they don't want to go through with it, they can reject it. But he believes that the money that's going to come out of this will clear all of Barcelona's debt. So which means there's going to be big money involved in the Super League. "I recognize that rebuilding the team should have been done a year ago. I hope that the time will highlight the assessment of the last 10 years, such as the 22 titles won by the football club." So that's what his last words. And it's just sad to see that he knows that we should have started rebuilding last year, and he decided to trust the players for one more year. Would have resolved a lot of our issues? Maybe. Would have kept his presidential status? Absolutely not. At the end of the day, this is a decision that he makes that makes everyone hates him. And he says that, you know, the football club won 22 titles over the past 10 years. You're only president for 6 of them. And during those 6, out of the 6, probably 4 of them, we've had some of our worst years in our history. So thanks for that. So in regards to the Super League, Javier Tebas, the La Liga president, who was also a Real Madrid fan, tweeted this out: "Unfortunate statement from Bartomeu and his last day as Barcelona on joining a weak and imaginary competition which could be their ruin. It confirms the ignorance about the football industry, a sad end for the president with success, but lately many mistakes." So he's just told that Barcelona may leave and join the Super League, because if Barcelona join the Super League, they will leave La Liga and not compete in La Liga anymore. And they may also leave the Champions League. So it's going to be basically a league of all the top clubs. So far, I think Manchester United, Liverpool, and Barcelona are the only three that have accepted the offers. Probably Real Madrid could accept it too. But it's going to be basically a league with all the top teams, and they just fight to see who wins, pretty much. And in my environment, no. I think everything the way it is absolutely fine. This quote, basically, from Tebas, is just, you know, looking out for himself. Because if Barcelona leaves the La Liga, then La Liga won't get any views. So that's what he's worried about in the situation. So I wouldn't look into it too much, but it's all going to be on the next board, whether we join the Super League or not. So after Bartomeu's press conference, and we've all known that he's going to leave now, Alfredo Martinez came out saying that according to the statutes, elections must be held between the next 40 to 90 days, which means the new president of Barcelona is going to happen in January. I think that's Barcelona's top goal right now, is to elect the new president before the January transfer window opens. That way they can get that window to start rebuilding and do what they want to do. But for now, Carlos Tusquets, it's basically Busquets, but with a T pretty much, Carlos Tusquets will be the new president of Barcelona until the presidential elections happen. So he's going to step in, take care of the everyday deals, and probably handle the wage cuts that's going to happen with the staff and the players as well. On the screen right now, you can see the list of all the new positions in Barcelona at the moment. So we have Carlos Tusquets as the president, Juan Rich as vice president, and you can see all the names. I'm not going to go through all the names, mainly because I can't pronounce them, but those are all the names right there of the new people in their positions at FC Barcelona. We'll have to worry about it too much, so they won't be in there for too long. There's some news regarding the aftermath of after Bartomeu resigned. So Robert Mario came out saying that if Koeman doesn't win any titles this season, there is a big chance that Xavi will be the new coach next season. This is what I like about this recognition, because now the whole pressure of the club is on Ronald Koeman's hands. If he does not succeed, he'll be out the door in no time. It's gonna be a big season for him now. he's going to have an immense amount of pressure on him, because he knows if he fails, he's out the door. They ain't going to, because, you know, Victor Font doesn't want him. Juan Laporta doesn't want him. They're going to give him a chance because he's already the coach. You know, if you win the titles, we'll keep you. So he's on a huge amount of pressure. This could be a one-season thing for him if he doesn't win anything. What I mean by winning is either the league or the Champions League. But the Copa del Rey, that does not count. If he wins only the Copa, he's still going to get sacked. You can trust me on that. Now, a reliable source has come out and saying that Lionel Messi's contract renewal is getting closer now. Hold your horses, boys and girls. I don't think this is any... This is coming from a super reliable source as well. I wouldn't look into it too much. I think the rumors will start to, you know, fluctuate as soon as the new president gets elected, because that is going to be his first task on hand, is getting Messi that contract renewal, because when January hits, he's allowed to talk to any club and sign a pre-contract agreement for free, and Barcelona cannot do anything to stop that. So the Barcelona president that's going to come in January is going to have a huge thing, huge massive task on his hand to get Messi to sign. Messi's opened the contract renewals. We all know that. Suarez said that after in his Atletico, I believe it's like his first interview as an Atletico player. He said that Messi's going to stay as long as there's a new board. It's looking bright for Messi, and hopefully we get that contract renewal signed before he agrees a contract with another team. So this next one's coming in from FF Polo saying, news update, Bartomeu, former president, love to see that, and current president Carlos Tusquets, who was in charge of the club until elections, had a three-hour meeting at the club offices today. In the meeting, Bartomeu has put Tusquets up to date to everything that's happening around the club and his resignation. Special importance was given on negotiations of players and workers regarding the salary reductions. Now the club has two open negotiations, one with the players and one with the ordinary workers, which must be closed by November 5th. Another hot topic on the table was the agreement to join the European Super League, as announced yesterday by Bartomeu, and an agreement of a great economic outcoming. And obviously the topic of election was discussed, which Tusquets has now between 40 days and 3 months to send out the dates. Everything has to be evaluated by the conditions of the pandemic as well. So Bartomeu basically telling Tusquets everything that's happening around the club right now, what stuff he needs to, you know, worry about before the elections. Like we said, Tusquets just coming in just to deal with everyday, you know, businesses. The two main things he's gonna have to look out for are the salary reductions of the staff and players, and of course the Super League agreement, which we all know is a thing. And I don't think he'll make an agreement on that. He'll probably just get, you know, the paperwork ready all for the new president. Then the new president will make that decision. So Tusquets, all you can expect from him from now until the elections is maybe him getting an agreement with the wages for the staff and the players. And that's pretty much it. Now you might be wondering how the players reacted to Bartomeu resigning. Well, we have it right here. The dressing room trusts the resignation of Bartomeu and what it thinks it will reduce the tension and, you know, a lot of the media, you know, coming out and attacking the players. They think it's going to be a lot less now. Players learned about the resignation of the board while having dinner at the Turin Hotel before the Juventus match yesterday. The reactions were diverse between approval and surprise. So no one was disappointed in his dismissal. There was just a group of players who were shocked that he did it and a group of players who were happy that he did it. I can tell you the leader of that group that were happy were probably Messi and Piqué. So let's move on. In any case, the staff approved Bartomeu's decision. They consider that from now on the noise will be reduced at the club, the environment, and the media. Bartomeu's relationship with some of the players were non-existent. Messi and Bartomeu have not spoken since the Boro fax in months. With Gerard Piqué, things were not also going great, as evident in his interview that he did with La Vanguardia. Obviously, the other players, Bartomeu's departure was a surprise. De Jong maintained a very good relationship with Bartomeu, although Marc-Andre ter Stegen learned about Bartomeu's departure from his home in Barcelona, as he was not in Turin and he wasn't match fit, of course, so he learned about it at his home in Barcelona. So it looks like the players, majority of them I would say, are happy that he's gone. A lot of them are just shocked, you know, the likes of Longlet, De Jong, Ter Stegen, those kind of players who were signed by Bartomeu. They're just a bit shocked, but they probably know deep down it was the right decision. And basically all the other players are just happy. So the big news around Barcelona yesterday that broke out was that management prefers to organize the presidential elections for December 19th and 20th. So Carlos Tusquets wants to get those elections done before January. The January 9 to 10 days is another option, but it would hamper the new board's plan in the winter January transfer window. So basically, the club wants to get the elections done before January, so that way the new president can have the January transfer window to work with. Because if you get elected in the middle, you're going to only have, you know, let's say election days are 9 and 10. He'll get, you know, inaugurated, you know, day 11, January 12th to do his speech, you know, saying welcome. He won't be in there until at least 15th of January, which is basically half the window done. So Barcelona, Carlos Tusquets and his staff really want to get the elections done before January transfer window. The race of the president of Barcelona starts now. Mundo Deportivo coming out on the front of their article. The five confirmed candidates are Victor Font, Toni Freixa, Jordi Ferra, and Benedito, who did the motion of no confidence first time in 2017 when Ernesto Valverde was the manager, and Fernandez Alay, Emel Roseld, who was a board member of Bartomeu's directors, has not announced his candidacy yet, but he said that he intends to run. Same goes for Juan Laporta. So I'm telling you guys this right now. The top two men are Victor Font and Juan Laporta. Juan Laporta obviously has this experience. He was a president in 2003-2010. Victor Font, he has the backing of Xavi. He's going to bring in Xavi. He has new ideas, and he wants to rebuild the club because he knows where the club comes from. So those are the two candidates I would look out for, Victor Font and Juan Laporta. So this next one's coming in from TV3, and this is it's probably the biggest story that's come out since Bartomeu resigned. And it is that the union of Juan Laporta and Victor Font cannot be ruled out yet. If these two men join forces to, you know, bring Barcelona back, it's going to be probably the best love story we've ever seen at Barcelona. Hopefully these two can come to an agreement and then work together, because if they work together, they're going to win the presidency by a landslide. But right now, I think it's like probably 60% Victor Font and 40% Juan Laporta. And if they just join forces, I think it's going to be great for the club. We'll see. They are in talks to join each other and, you know, run together. So let's not get ahead of ourselves. But right now, they are separate. Victor Juan Laporta has not announced that he's running yet, but he's going to. And Victor Font already has his project out there. Finally, some news just to end off this video. Couture have come out with two stories. First one is that after Bartomeu announced his resignation, a certain player in the dressing room joked around by saying that he would put champagne in the fridge. I tell you what, whoever that player is, please let yourself know so we can all adore you. Probably PK or Messi, let's be honest. And finally, as you can see on the screen, this was Messi training the morning of the Juventus match, because Koeman likes to train in the morning of a game as well. It was a light training session, and Messi came out with a smile on his face. Probably the first smile we've seen since the moral fact was sent, and you just love to see it. So that's all the news that's come out since Bartomeu resigned as FC Barcelona president. Just a quick recap, he's resigned, he's gone, Carlos Tusquets is going to come in. The two main things he's going to have to deal with is the acceptance of the Super League and the players and staff's wage reduction. That's the only thing he's going to have to take care of until the new president comes in. Elections are set to be on December 19th and 20th, but it's not confirmed yet. They just want to have it before the January transfer window. And all the players are very happy that Bartomeu has resigned. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you leave a like, comment. I love reading you guys' comments. I respond to every single comment. If you want to leave your opinion down below, I will always respond to that. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you guys next time on the channel, probably tomorrow, for the Deportivo Alaves and Barcelona match preview. So I'll see you guys then. Take care, and Forza Barca. No!